A blessed Easter, Christ is risen. We are gathered on the third Sunday of the Easter season. We just celebrated Holy Mass for the good people of O'Neill's, and we just wanted to give you a hello, a little update on how things are going. As you can tell, there are some changes. I tried to cut my own hair, and it went south, but the Holy Spirit said, let it go. Get rid of the vanity. And I really think during this time of pandemic and isolation, God's saying, focus on me. A lot of times I find in my own life, we focus on so many things, and we're always saying, I wish I had more time for God. I wish I had more time to pray. I wish I had more time to say the rosary. Do it. This is the time. Don't worry about when you're going to get a haircut, or when you're going to go to the salon and have your nails done, or go to get the massage, or go to do this, or go to do that. Don't worry about it. Focus on God because he focuses on you. Father Don gave a beautiful homily this morning on that fact in Emmaus. Jesus was focused on those disciples who were focused on only their worries and their dread and their failure and their disappointment. But Jesus said, look up, I'm here. And that's what he does for us too. And I know it's been long, I know it's been tough, but in actuality, it's almost been 2 months, which in the grand scheme of things isn't that long compared to what our brothers and sisters in the faith have gone through in the past. We're in this together. Let go of the vanity and let Christ walk with you. Maybe not on the road to Emmaus, but on this road in Fairview Park and beyond.
It's good to have this opportunity just to greet you. And Jesus was recognized in the breaking of the bread, and we long for that happy day. Please, God, may it come soon, that we will be united at this table before you right now, joined in spirit and in joy. One of the ways I try to fill my days is going out for walks. And sometimes many of you have been waving at me and shouting out as a joy to connect even in the simplest ways to neighbors and friends. And in my private time, I've been going through photo albums from my youth, looking at pictures of my parents when they were young and my brothers and I when we were all just young boys. We had such camaraderie, and life seemed so simple and joyful in those early days. And I take a moment to thank God for memory. That is so a powerful human experience. We human beings are gifted with the treasure of memory. We know our past. We know we have loved and cared for deeply. And we have so many fond, nostalgic experiences that make our spirits soar. May they soar heavenward to the origin of all that is good, to Christ himself, risen from the grave, and master and teacher of us all. Look forward to seeing you.
Good morning to all of you. And again, we are thinking about you and praying for you. Lots of things to pray for this week. We have not heard yet, as of this recording, about when things may be starting to get back to normal. It is a big decision to make because, as we have discussed, we don't know yet who has been stricken with the virus, who is a carrier, etc. So I think that the state of Ohio, especially in the dioceses of Ohio, want to err on the side of good health. And so we ask God's help for us to be patient. Father Rob said it very wonderfully, and I was thinking about this the other day. We've been watching sometimes together the Roosevelt story on television. And you think back in previous generations of those who were in the First World War, how long did that go? Those who suffered the years of depression, those who suffered many years of the Second World War, the Cold War, the Vietnam conflict, all the different things that people have gone through, and we've been going through this, what, two months, right? And that doesn't mean that it's not difficult. It's very difficult. The world is different than it was back then, but it calls upon us just as it did previous generations to have the gift of patience. just patience with others, but are you patient with yourself? That's a big deal, I think. I'm not often patient with myself, and I get a little crazy sometimes, and the gift of humor will help that. And to be forgiving of youngsters who are caught at home, be forgiving of spouses, be forgiving of anyone who, we can all drive each other crazy sometimes. We're very lucky, we live in a big house, and we don't often drive each other crazy, so thanks be to God. At least I hope that, that's true. And it's also, we're thinking about you, we're praying for you, we're talking to you on the phone. I hope that you will continue to remember all those who are ill, who are suffering long-term illness. They need your support and prayer. I just spoke to a family the other day, a young girl in our parish had her second miscarriage. She's had a stillborn birth, and it's very trying for her, as you can imagine, and for her whole family, her spouse, and everyone. So please keep her in mind. We know that in God's good grace, she will bring in new life. But let's pray for the gift of life for her and for her young child who passed away. Let's also consider all the kids. You may have seen these wonderful signs around that the teachers of our school put in around, and it says, your teachers miss you, and also your St. Angela Marici family is thinking of you. Remember to keep laughing, loving, and learning. And you should remember, always tell a good story, tell a few good jokes. Remember the story of Mark Twain? Mark Twain was he was very impatient with his father when he was a young man, about 17 years old or so. And he said his father was probably one of the most unintelligent people he had ever met. And then when Mark Twain was 21 years old, he said it was surprising how much my father learned in those few years. So think about that if you would. I'd also like to thank you again for supporting the parish. It means a great deal to us. We appreciate that. Don't forget to stay 6 feet apart. And I'd like to share with you the prayer we shared today with the people at a meal, which is the spiritual communion prayer that the Holy Father has given to us. If I can find it quickly on my phone, as my finger does. Walking, remember that?
Remember the old pages.
Walking through the yellow pages. If you're young and you don't remember what the yellow pages were, talk to your parents and grandparents. And also, a good thing to remember, see if you can name all 50 states and the capitals of all 50 states. And when you get finished with that, try Europe and South America, etc., right? And then try Africa after that. So here's the prayer for a spiritual communion. Let us pray. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Let us say, Amen. And may the gospel today inspire us to be renewed with Jesus. We are very sad that we cannot share the breaking of the bread with you, believe me. And we long for the day when we can share it together. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us share the blessing. May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit descend upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. St. Angela Marici,
pray for us.
Mary, help for the sick.
Pray for us.
All of our patron saints,
pray for us.
God bless you all.
Thank you.
God bless everybody.